What's up, spectators? Welcome back to the episode of Zero Time Dilemma, Zero Escape. Welcome back to Zero number 3. So we're going to do Q Team now, because last time we did C Team, which was the Rec Room. That's right, the machine guns and the dice. Yeah. So now we only have two left for Q Team. Hold on. Okay. Oh man, okay. Let's go ahead and pick one of these. Sure. Radical 6.
Huh? Why? Nope. It won't even budge.
Ah! The hell is that?
Shut up.
Formaldehyde solution with
a pig.
It's okay, Mira. I'm right here with you.
Ugh. We're in the bio lab, right?
So there's a bunch of biological research here.
Jeez, this place is really creepy. Why is something like this in a bomb shelter?
Maybe the builders thought to be prepared for some kind of pandemic.
Pandemic?
An infectious disease that hits on a global scale. It's like a sudden deadly virus outbreak.
Maybe this place is an isolated location for researching all kinds of viruses like that.
Oh, okay.
Or maybe Zero put it here in order to do something to us.
Like what?
Like maybe taking the ingredients and cooking all of us a nice meal.
Ugh.
Look at how lame this lab is.
Isn't it?
Can't research crap in this one.
Too early for dinner?
It's been 4.5 hours since we fell asleep in the lounge.
4.5 hours. They knocked us out for quite a while.
No, not necessarily.
I enjoy that we have to say this every time.
We could have woken up a bunch of times during all that. But if Zero erased our memories?
Of course. We wouldn't remember.
No.
Wow, look at that computer!
Slash the pig's stomach.
Whoa, you can play all kinds of games on this!
Would that mean that we...
Probably.
But can it play Crisis?
Why? Why do we have to do something like that?
I have no idea, but it's not like we really have a choice, do we?
Why?
There's no way to leave. We're just gonna have to do what he said.
I guess what's annoying is, if he ever got any braver from all of his experiences and desensitized, it's erased because of the memory injection thingy. So he's always gonna be a wuss. Come on, back it up. Where's that pig doll? You know what? I'm gonna keep it and see how long I can keep all that crap on. Okay, why have I forgotten how to move? Okay. Where is the, there. There's a dotted line on this pillow. Maybe we're supposed to slash this pig. It'd be a lot easier if it is. No harm in trying. Yes, we can't tear it. Why is it only this one piece of the model red? It fell out, and I barely touched it. I swear. Did I break it? Maybe we could use it for something. Let's take it. Okay. This looks like a researcher's note. They must have been doing research on cells. I know, it's telling us to look at the cells in the microscope. Careful examination of the green and pink liquids reveal two different cell structures. Okay. Separating the liquid results in different colors. One thing is clear after inspecting the separated liquids. The cell structure is unique for each color. Okay. This piece from the model. Doesn't it have this whole same hole shape as the screws? I think we can unscrew with this. Covers off. Okay, something with two slits. So we got the cover off, but what exactly is this? Any ideas? It's a centrifuge. I might have seen it before, or not. Maybe I would have known before I lost my memories. You put the vials in, and it'll spin around real fast. Set the dial to A to mix the liquid. Set the dial to B to separate the liquid. Must be the manual for the centrifuge. Place the tubes with liquid. Mixture into one beaker. Got it. There sure are a lot of tools. Wonder what they're for. I don't think anything here is useful. Let's leave them then. Who knows what would happen if we moved them. There's a sink on this thing. I found this in here. There. That knife looks pretty sharp. Maybe we can use it to cut open the pig's stomach. Why is the sink like this? Why is it faced this way? That is weird. Isn't this sink kind of weird? The faucet's on the other side. You're right. You can't use a well like this. And no water's coming out. Wait a minute! Oh, the knob is gone. The red thingy. There's a sink and some caster wheels at the bottom. Maybe we can move it. We can try. It's not moving an inch. I think it's locked in place. Some suspicious liquid. It won't explode if we mix it, will it? Like mad scientists do, right? That's an old-fashioned reference. This is a clean bench. It's for preventing contamination of samples while working. What kind of contamination? Substances like microorganisms, bacteria, things that shouldn't get mixed in samples. You really know your stuff. A microwave! I don't think there's any point to putting that in there. Well, that's not what I want to do. What's this thing? It's a UV irradiator. It's used mostly for drying and strengthening adhesive materials. So not for toasting your skin to a beautiful tan, then. Okay, it strengthens adhesive bonds. There's a jar here that's missing. It's a specimen of some kind of plant. Maybe it's an experimental plant that can live in a polluted world. Sounds like the setup for a man-eating flower from a bee movie. This is a seahorse. What is a seahorse anyway? A kind of shrimp or starfish? Snake? They're a type of fish. It's hard to tell, but they do have gills. This is a butterfly specimen. That's weird. I can't move it. It looks like this is the only one locked in place. What could that mean? There's a penguin in there. It's so sad there in that specimen jar. Really? It's dead, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. Four buttons, each a different color. This might be... You think if we got the combination right, this thing would open? I think so too, let's try it. I don't think this opens. Looks like it's grown-up's turn now. It won't open. Maybe it's broken, let's keep looking around. I'm willing to- oh, hold on. Alright, I'm gonna do it! Looks like there's a bunch of things inside. Let's take all of them. The incubation period for this virus is extremely short. Mortality rate is 100%. Symptoms include blood erupting from the body, then death. Huh. Interesting. Microscope lens. Power cord. What's this paper? Fanatic BioR? Never heard of it. I want to see too. Would you just shut it? This is why kids are... Give me a sec. I can't see anything. How exactly are you going to see anything without the lens? slap it on. I think we can use this now. Let's look at something in the microscope. Okay. It's fuzzy to see, okay. Okay. Still saying it's too fuzzy to see. Too fuzzy to see. Too fuzzy to see. And the beaker's in place. Let's start the separating process. Looks like they cleanly separated. Okay. Oops, wrong one. Okay. The yellow liquid cells are in groups of five. Hold on, let me write this down. I saved that piece of paper from before. Yellow. Group of five. Back it up. Blue. Two. The cells in the blue liquid attach together in twos. All right, let's go back. Back. White, yep, red and white. White is one. Okay. Red is three. Perfect. We got everything we need. Go back. Go over here. All right. Five. Two. One. Three. It's unlocked. Good job. Pretty amazing for a kid your age. I won't lose next time. What's this box? Transparent specimens. I think we could fit all of these in the box. Let's find out. Fuck! Okay. Here we go. Finally, okay. This wasn't as bad as the other one. Capsules? What do we need these for? Are we supposed to take them? I don't really like capsule pills. They have to be cherry flavored. What? They don't need a flavor. You swallow them. You don't chew on them. Eric, you aren't still taking children's cough syrup, are you? Interesting. These capsules, he's not telling us that we have to take them, is he? Maybe if we mix them with something, they'll give us a clue. These are the pills I wouldn't want to take. Oh, right. Hmm. Nothing else in here. Hmm, pills. What to do with pills? Oof. Oof. There's nothing on the monitor. Do you think we could use this, the computer, to do research? I don't think so. Let's keep looking. Are we sure? The power turned on, but we can't use it yet. It looks like it's on standby mode. The cover over there opened up. What could that be? There's a thin hole on the side. Maybe it'll turn off if we stick something in. Thin and long. I think the knife will fit inside the hole. It fits perfectly. The analyzer's on. Can't believe using a knife for the lever actually worked. Me neither. And if we take the knife out, we can still use it. The blade broke off inside, and now it's useless as a knife.
Idiot! Look what you did!
How are we going to cut the pig open now? I didn't mean to pull so hard. It's all over. Zero's gonna kill us all now. What's done is done. The analyzer's still on, at least. We'll find another way. What if I did this before I cut the pillow open? This thing will analyze liquids, right? It'll show results if you put 3 dishes of liquid in. So let's do that and see what happens. 3 dishes of liquid. Let's put this liquid in first. Whoa, whoa, whoa! That's not what I meant to do. I guess that was the wrong set. Was there a hint around here anywhere? It's probably the pills. That's the hint. I still think this pig is the one, but the big question is, how do we get it out? Time to prove I'm a man. Oh, my hand! Not even a crack! What the hell are you? I still have this power cord, but why? Slash the pig's stomach. What could that mean in a place like this? I guess I could try making, hold on. And then, let me put the red one in. Okay, so now I have purple. The question is, okay, we have 4 colors. Okay, it looks like I was doing it wrong entirely. Well, I had the right idea, which was that I would need to mix different vial colors to get what we need, but I thought it was the pills that were trying to give me the clue. It's once you put the cover inside that microwave, that's what I like what I'm calling it, the microwave. You can clearly see the 3 platters. It's orange, blue, and white. Okay, orange, blue, and white. Alright, hold on. Alright, orange, blue, and white. I got it. I can do this. So let's re-separate this. Okay. Alright. Now, if I need orange, blue, and white, I need to get red and yellow. Spin. Now it should be orange. Orange, blue, and white. Right. Okay. No! Fire! Okay. Wow, that's annoying. Okay. Go, 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 go. Please, please just go back. Thank you. Okay. Now, here, orange, blue, white. We did it! No matter how bad the situation is, solving a problem always cheers you up. There's something in there. A specimen cylinder. Looks like there's a human fetus inside. Fetus? That big? I don't know about that. You can call it a fetus, but that thing's ginormous. That's like 6 months in development. What's wrong? Why are you turning your head away like that? Oh, it's scary. Oh, hello! What are these symbols? Five symbols with five colors, all different. It could be a hint. Yeah. That looks just like this. So, what's the connection? Alright, hold on. Green. Bird. Oh, penguin! That's a penguin. Penguin. Purple is the seahorse. White, dragonfly, a butterfly. I'm trying to remember what the actual ones are in the specimen jars. Red, what the heck is that? Sun? I don't know. Blue, human. Now, let's see how this works, because three of them have two missing. Two, three, four, one is five, one is ten. Let's see, blue. Green, five, purple. Two, white, zero. Okay. All right, let's give this a shot. A perfect fit, but nothing's happening. Maybe the positions are wrong. Okay. Oh, boy. Hold on. Maybe the colors are related to... hold on. Hold on. I have an idea. How do you move them? I can only move the... Oh, no. Oh, right. I can't move the butterfly. That's the clue. Okay. The butterfly is white, which is zero. Butterfly is white, zero. What? Oh, my God. You're not gonna believe this. I've been trying to figure out the solution to this for so long because it doesn't make sense, right? What's missing? So I was like, okay, maybe the first column, there's something important about the missing, or the second column, or the back, or the number. It's none of that. It's so simple. If you, it's actually infuriating. Okay, so if you haven't noticed, this looks awfully like a 1, right? Well, this looks like a 2, and this is a 3, and this is a 5, which means that's 4, which is probably the one we can't touch in the first place, which is white. Ah, it's so dumb. It's so dumb. Oh, I never saw it. I didn't see it. I gotta redraw this now. Green, 1. Purple, 2. Blue, 3. Orange, or red, 5. God damn it. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. One is penguin. Two is seahorse. Three is human. Son of a gun, man. Now I see. That's how it goes. I'm glad you're here. Oh, it's nothing. I knew it too, of course. I noticed way before. Hey, don't ignore me. Some kind of machine came out. A fingerprint authentication device. Do we have to prove our identities now? What if the exit opens if we do it? Let's just try it out. I thought it just wanted a fingerprint. What is this? Was this some sort of trap? I'm bleeding. That hurt. What's that sound? Maybe that means we passed the authentication. Look over there. The light by the sink turned on. Okay. The green light turned on. It must mean there's power. Did anything change? Well, let's see. This thing. It can move? Still doesn't work, no water. There are caster wheels on it. We have to get the pig out. My fist though kind of hurts. There's a drawer here. It's a scalpel. We can probably use it. Let's take it with us. It's stuck again. I think I heard a click when it stopped. Now the light on the equipment over there turned on. So that means that one can be moved too. The green light here turned on. We have power. And now we can move it. Now the light's red. Did I do something wrong? Get away from there! Oh, okay, that's weird. Ugh, this thing's heavy, and the smell is disgusting. Quit whining and move it. Didn't you want to prove you were a man? You could do it, Eric. Hello, Mr. Piggy. What? Why not? The power's on, but it still doesn't work. No water. Okay. Oh! So we have to slash the pig's stomach. You got this. I'll be cheering you on from over here. I can't believe you. You make me sick, Eric! The pig's all set, and I have the scalpel. But where do I start cutting? Oh, for crying out loud, give me the scalpel. So clean. Does your family own a farm, Mira? Something like that. Now let's see what's hiding inside this thing. Yeah, don't ask questions.
Zero.
17 years ago, a woman died. Her chest carved open with a sharp object. Just like that pig man. What difference? That woman was alive. Her heart was still beating as the organs truly carved out of her. A male suspect was quickly caught. He must have planned to escape via taxi, as he caught one before his capture. The police arrested him before he was able to utilize the waiting vehicle to flee the scene. Instead, a genius surgeon climbed inside. He was heading to the hospital. A seriously ill patient awaited his arrival for life-saving treatment. However, the taxi got into an accident before reaching its destination. It collided with a large truck. The resulting wreck was horrendous. Sadly, as a result of this accident, the driver and surgeon died, as well as the young boy waiting for surgery. Life is truly unfair.
What is the point of him telling us this story?
It's just some kind of act, right? Probably doesn't mean anything. I'm not sure.
Now then, let's begin our game, shall we? The rules are as follows.
What, did he like get all those people and put them as a group?
Contain three syringes. Each of them is filled with a specific virus called Radical 6.
It's super radical.
Radical 6?
This virus is special. It awakens a desire to kill oneself, among other things. Once infected, symptoms appear as early as 10 minutes, or take up to 2 hours. And the host soon finds the urge to commit suicide irresistible. The mortality rate is 75%.
Oh, okay. There's a chance.
It's highly contagious. Oh yes, I believe you located a set of documents during your search of this room. A set of files on FBR, the fanatic bio-R virus.
Franklin Bolano Roosevelt.
The mortality rate of this virus is 100%. Infection results in blood erupting from your body. An antagonistic relationship exists between Radical 6 and FBR. If you were to be infected by Radical 6, it would be cancelled out with the addition of FBR, and you are unaffected. Conversely, injecting Radical 6 into you after becoming infected with FBR will cause them to destroy each other and leave no adverse effects on you.
So, a single virus is toxic, but using the other as a vaccination provides an antidote.
Now, here's an important piece of information for you. I am what you'd call a clairvoyant, one who knows the future.
What is he talking about?
If I had foreseen that you would all choose to inject Radical 6 at this moment, I would have made sure to coat FBR on the fingerprint authentication device for you. Meaning, you'd already be infected with the fanatic bio-R virus.
That device over there?
Oh, I do remember feeling something when I touched it. Like a prick.
So we were all stabbed by a poison needle?
On the other hand, if I saw that you were not going to inject yourselves with Radical 6, then I would be sure to leave the needle clean. That way, you don't become infected with fanatic bio-R.
Wait, what? What are you saying?
I'll say it once more. If all of you plan to inject yourselves with Radical 6, you already have FBR. If you are not going to inject yourselves, then you are not infected right now. Which means, in either case, you being saved is a foregone conclusion. There's no reason for you to worry about the situation. What will you do now? Inject yourselves with Radical 6, or refrain? It would be best to consider gambling.
So,
I will say that your decision.
Well, no, because I'm going to make the decision twice, idiot. Zero, you so stupid!
So wait, do we even need to choose?
Huh?
If what Zero told us is the truth, then the outcome will be the same. If we inject ourselves with this Radical 6, we're already infected with FBR. So they destroy each other and we're fine. And if we don't do it, that just means we weren't infected with FBR in the first place.
But what if it's a lie?
Huh?
He's saying, what if he's lying about being psychic? Well, if you think about it, the likelihood that he's lying is incredibly high.
It doesn't matter.
So then, what do we do?
Just do what you want. You just pick
one.
What
the hell do we do?
What the If I did only have one choice, though. And I had to live with that choice. I would inject it. Clean needle my butt. But! Okay, see, now I don't remember which one's which. So, we were injected with the blood one, right? Where we died from the blood? Not the
Let's
suicide one?
Why?
Care to share your reason?
After everything, the issue isn't if Zero can see the future or if he's lying. It's just like Eric said, if Zero does have that power, then it's the same either way.
That means all we need to do is think about what happens if he doesn't. Our fate can go four different ways if that's the situation. If we are infected with FBR and we inject ourselves with Radical 6, or not. If we aren't infected with FBR and we inject ourselves with Radical 6, or not. The important thing we need to remember, though, is the mortality rates. Zero said the casualty rate is 75% for the Radical 6 virus. And we saw in the files that death is 100% confirmed for Fnatic Bio-R. So we can use that to determine it.
There you go!
It's clear which option is best, right?
Where'd you get the marker and the paper?
The probability that we're infected with FBR is 2-1, which means if we inject Radical 6, our survival rate is half of 125, 62.5%.
And if we don't inject it, then our chance is sitting at 50%.
Any objections? Okay.
What was that sound?
Here we go.
What was that? Was it anything?
Ready? And...
Why would you choose there? Why would you over your wrist? Eh. All right, party!
So are we good? Did we do the right thing?
The lab door opened afterwards, so we must have.
Do you feel any different?
No, not really.
So, I guess?
Oh no, I want to kill myself!
Hey, Eric. I've thought this before, but, well, your laugh is kind of strange.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess this is, well, sort of a bad habit I've had since I was a kid.
What do you mean?
Issues at home, I guess.
Was your family difficult?
That's just it. We were completely normal. A kind mom, a clumsy dad, and an annoying little brother.
But your mom was murdered, or your dad died in a car accident. Telling you, they're all related, ma'am.
Oh, dear. What's wrong?
I'm not sure. They've just been crying.
Hey, you two.
Mind is that Sigma's voice?
Why you're crying?
Chris broke my toy!
No! It was your fault, Eric!
Chris, Eric, listen to me, okay? When painful or sad things happen, people get angry or cry because of them. But even at those times, I want you to never forget to smile.
Smile?
Yes.
Smile. Creeping me out, man! Don't look at me!
No matter how painful things get, as long as you can face it with a smile, happiness will come to you. Smiles have a strength.
Stop! Close your mouth!
Really?
Yes, really. And that's not all. A smile can make everyone all around you happy, too.
You too, Mommy? You'll be happy, too?
Oh no! Absolutely not!
Why don't you two stop?
I hate children!
And show Mom your smile.
Okay.
Yeah!
You sure are something else.
Thanks, Sigma.
Hey, what about me? Can Daddy get some smiles too?
No, Sigma!
Oh dear, it looks like Daddy's lonely, you two. Let's all give him a whole lot of smiles.
God, can you imagine having parents that sound like that? Everyone smile! Let's go for the hugs!
You've gotten big.
Me too. Me too!
Shut up, Eric!
Okay. Come at me. I'm ready.
Yay!
This happened last week. He's remembering a memory from last week. They're like, Eric, you're so big.
Never forget to smile. She'd never hurt a bug. Not even if a line of ants crossed her path. She was that kind and gentle.
Yeah, but she had her heart ripped out.
She was incredible. And when we lost her, that's when Dad changed.
Dad started drinking. What did I say?
Shut the hell up! Who said you could fucking cry?
Chris!
Oh, Jesus, Eric! Can't you even look after your shitty little brother?
I'm sorry! Forgive me, please forgive me!
God! Fucking kids.
That was a 180.
Go find someone to get me beer!
I love how there's no middle ground. It's both extremes. One is, come for your hugs. Love is everywhere. Two,
I'm just gonna beat you because I need some beer money.
Eventually, I figured out how to smile, regardless of what was going on. Just smiling day in and day out. No fun, not happy. I'd be made fun of or yelled at. No matter the pain, no matter how bad it was, I never raised my voice. I just kept smiling. I didn't stop, even after Dad fell ill and died. So I guess the two smiles, one taught by my mom and one forced by my dad, got kind of mixed up, and the result is what I pasted on my face.
Eric, she's...
I've never talked to anyone about all of this before, but... Mira, will you still love me? Even with me being like this?
Oh, never now! Yeah, idiot. Never.
Yeah.
You're gross. You're right.
I didn't even have to ask, did I?
Eric, thanks for sharing that.
Eric, thanks for sharing.
You or anything.
It's too bad you also like beating kids.
Just sort of
so I hate
out.
You.
That's all.
Yeah. Still, thanks.
Of course, no one remembers.
I just didn't want to end up like my father. So I forced my mouth to keep smiling through everything.
Even as I punch kids.
The worst part of me still came to the front after we got trapped here. I pushed all of that on you, too.
Yeah?
Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
I'm all right.
Okay.
Yeah, you're lucky you got that helmet on.
So, you never mentioned you had a younger brother.
Yeah. About your age, more or less.
That is his brother!
What? We're the same age?
What? I'm your brother?
Maybe we could be friends.
Maybe I'm your brother.
Would it be okay if I met him after we get out?
No, because I'm me. I'm your brother.
Well. Anyway, sorry I turned the mood dark.
You turned the mood. Oh, your jokes always crack me up, Eric.
Huh?
I mean, to think that was dark. You really have a sense for these things.
The sound.
Don't worry. Listening to it was a lot of
fun. Wait a minute. What makes you think that was all a joke?
Uh-huh.
It was such a sad story. He just told us he's been holding in this painful past the whole time. How is that a joke?
Oh, I just didn't think to make a mistake like that.
A mistake?
I'm so sorry. I've always been clumsy. It's at times like these that I don't even know how to look, you know?
Clumsy?
Hey, Eric. Can you tell me?
Mira.
What? Oh. But why? Why though?
What?
Those hands. Ah!
No. Mira? Why did you?
That's a good question. Bum bum bum. Not too soon.
What's wrong with you, Mira?
Poop is physics.
Stop! Stop this! No!
But why? Are you bored? This is not even an explanation! They're not gonna explain it. She's not gonna explain herself. Well, there's no one to explain to because she killed them all. Doesn't make sense. Why? I guess that'd be like super confusing if you hadn't done that, this one first. Oop, go back. Wait. Okay, yes, okay. So I have two things I need to do. This, I can do no one. Then I can go back to this one and do the not the poison thing. But I'm really curious to do this one. Bum bum. Bum bum bum. Bum bum. Here we go. Got ourselves a Mexican standoff. I went for my keyboard again, every time. Yeah, nice! I bet you'll kill us both!
I'll just slowly put my weapon down first. So now, you two?
Yeah, okay.
Sure.
Sure.
We're dead, yo. We're so dead. Eric, you cunt!
No!
Wow. Oh, I'm toast.
What an idiot.
Fuck you, Eric. I'm glad you're always dying.
The current casualties. CT, Carlos, Junpei. QT, Q. DT, Diana. Five, Sigma. These six are now deceased. As a result, six X-passes will be revealed.
Huh, they didn't make me type it in this time.
Let's go, Mira! Let's get out of here. Build a happy home and wonderful future together.
She's probably gonna blow his brains out right now. Woo! I killed a boy! God, I hope she kills you real good, Eric. In almost any work of fiction, I'm gonna enjoy the crazy person. The craziest person. Who doesn't?
I don't think I could be any happier. I have you, Mira. And this bed is super comfy. I couldn't ask for anything more. Isn't that right?
Yeah, right.
I hope we can be like this every day. Forever.
And who?
Ever and.
Oh no! What a twist! So yeah, Eric, I mean, you're a dick. So, that's what happens when you're a dick. Yep. Oh, right, we're not done yet. Back here. And go.
What is that?
Oh, so many words. But he won't. No, thank you.
We shouldn't.
Yeah, right?
Care to share your reason?
After everything, the issue isn't if Zero can see the future or if he's lying. It's just like Eric said, if Zero does have that power, then it's the same either way. That means all we need to do is think about what happens if he doesn't have powers. The important thing to determine is if we're actually infected if we are.
So you don't think we are, then?
No. A virus called Fanatic Bio-R existing in the first place is very suspicious.
Radical 6 sounds just as fantastical.
No. There's no doubt that Radical 6 is real. I've heard of it before. Well, it could be that Zero wants us to become infected with Radical 6. But instead of doing it himself, for some reason he's unable to.
So he needs us to do it ourselves, then.
That's nonsense. He moves us around all the time.
Hey, what the...
The door.
Or at least the person working for him,
it
you
opened.
Know? He's always got a lackey.
Let's get out of here. If we're too slow, then the door might up and close on us.
Wait, Eric!
Ho 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 ho.
Hey, Mira! What are you doing?
Oh, very interesting. Party!
We must have been right not to inject it. I still feel okay, and more importantly, the door opened for us.
There's still another possibility, you know. That Zero really does have the ability to see the future.
If it's true, then we would have been right if we had injected the needles, too.
Hey, did you tell the truth earlier?
About what?
About Radical 6 being real.
Oh, yeah.
How do you know about it?
Well, I'm not sure.
Did you get any more suspicious?
I know what I know, okay? I can't help that.
So, why not share? Tell us more about this Radical 6 virus.
More. I'm not even sure where to start.
How about its name?
Oh, that's easy.
Well, it was made in the 1970s, and these hippie scientists were like, ooh, this is super radical.
Radical 6 thought process to reduce by 1√6. Therefore, when 1 second passes for them, the world has gone through √6 seconds, or roughly 2.45 seconds. There is also the word radical. Aside from meaning things like extreme, it can also refer to a radical root. Get it?
Oh, so that's why it's Radical 6.
But is it really possible for thought speed to be slowed down like that?
Yep. The infected, through changes in DNA methylation and histone modification, gain epigenetic mutations in the control mechanisms of their genetic expressions.
Wait!
Duh!
Could you maybe simplify that, please?
Oh, the body's composition changes as a genetic switch is flipped, more or less.
A genetic...
switch?
Huh. Let's try this. A common scientific thought until now was that parental characteristics didn't transfer. Recent research has changed that. We now know that they can be by flipping certain genetic switches. Well, regardless of what kind of experiences the parents had to go through, their DNA blueprints won't change. But within that expansive DNA coding, the question of what should be read seems to change based on experience. The change becomes especially apparent when the parents' lives are in danger.
Like maybe if someone was trapped in a shelter and forced to risk their life.
So if Eric and I did the horizontal tango right now, the baby might end up psychic.
What?
Anyway, so if that really does flip the genetic switch... Hey, are you listening?
Yeah. So, you're basically saying this Radical 6 virus is super dangerous, right?
Yes, there's no doubt it is. So, Zero said earlier that Radical 6 transmits through bodily fluids and is highly infectious. If someone infected with the virus was to go outside, then... Mankind, 6 billion people, will die.
6 billion?
Now announcing the current casualties. C-Team, Carlos, Akane, Junpei. These three are now deceased. As a result, 3 X-passes will be revealed. Fire. Crash. 5. That is all.
What the hell? C-Team is dead?
It's obviously because of the vote.
The vote?
At 1330.
Then... But wait! Did everyone from C-Team really die? We haven't seen their corpses or anything! They might still be alive!
No. They're dead. I'm sure of it.
Why?
Because...
Interesting that Eric is caring all of a sudden.
He's right. I don't think they're alive.
You too, Mira? What do you think, old man? C-Team's gotta be alive, right?
They're dead!
What are you doing, Eric? He's not gonna answer you.
Hey, you don't know. Maybe he...
can speak?
He's Zero.
Now it is time for you to sleep.
Zero.
When next you wake, know you will have no memory of these past 90 minutes. Pleasant dreams.
Now there's a route where we could be infected and go suicidal. Wait, oh gosh, it's so confusing. Whew. Radical 6, all sections cleared! Let's look at the flow. What's this? I really wish they had a picture with it, because I don't know what that means. Drink. Or don't drink. Anthropic principle, then, okay, right. Man, what is this? We haven't even touched this, or this! Look at that! Who killed Junpei? Who killed Junpei? So by making the correct choice, it ascends into this? Wait a minute. Are you telling me I never put Akane? Wait. Are you telling me that in all the times I've gone back to fix the choices I haven't finished, I haven't put Akane as the other choice? Is that what you're saying? Hold on. This one? No freaking way! No freaking way! I guess we'll get to that in the next... Oh, God. Hold on, is anything new? No, nothing new. Alright then, well, stay tuned for the next episode, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye!